Is that India? What happened to her hair?
Well, if I want to shave it close, so I want to rock locks that'll take a bit away from the soul that I got.
Hey there. So I'm coming at you today because I am doing the See My Healthy Hair Grow 2011 Growth Challenge. And a little bit later on, I am going to be posting videos of my hair length to start. This is starting 1 month. I'm in January, so since it'll be the last day, I will be sure to make a video with the current length of my hair. This video is for me requests to put on what we're doing to prepare for the challenge. And I just wanted to get right into a few of the things that I got to prepare for the challenge. Some of the things I had already and some I picked up when I decided to start the challenge, and some I just picked up to prepare for actually starting it at my local beauty supply store. The first thing that I got was clips. I got a packet of these. I don't know how many. I ripped the top off, like 12 of them. I also picked up a ouchless comb. You can see that. It's by Goody. It has a pretty wide teeth in here in the comb, and then it also has this little section, if you see this area up here, so that it could relieve resistance. To relieve some resistance, and hopefully by the time that it's flexing, I would feel it and be able to take it out before it breaks my hair. I also picked up some coconut papaya. It's by a company called Nubian Heritage, and I thought it was so cute because when I went to their website, oh no, not even on the website, on the bottle, it says 100% black owned and proud of it. I joke to you not. That's what it says at the bottom there. It's called, it's by a company called Black Heritage, not Black Heritage, Nubian Heritage, and it's coconut and papaya shampoo. It's all natural, ultra moisturizing growth stimulant with shea butter, aloe vera, and vitamin E. It's a shampoo. Literally, it just has coconut oil soap, sugar soap, filtered water, vegetable glycerin, coconut milk, shea butter, cascarilla bark extract, pannitol, which is provitamin B5, aloe vera gel, vitamin E, and rosemary extract for all hair types. So I picked up some of that. It was not cheap. This little 8 ounce was $8.49. And you know, I'm used to getting like the bigger ones, like the motions, for like $4 or $5, and this little, and theirs are usually like 13 to 16 ounces. Anyway, so I got that. I also got, this is called Grow Works Stop the Breakage, Love the Growth conditioning treatment, and this one is a leave-in. It's very liquidy. I can show, I hope, oh! Oops. I'm gonna scrape that up. So I can't really show it to you. Ooh, I shouldn't open this. I've had problems with it since I bought it, like literally from the store. I had to clean it. Here it is, Grow Works. Sorry if that looks a little messy, people. Okay, I'll just rub that in my hair. so I got that. I also picked up, just quickly, I picked up some soft twist rolls. These are the twist, I think everyone calls them twisty ties. Roll up your hair and they bend, you just twist them and do like that. There's six in a pack. I got four packs of six in the 11 and 16 diameter. What they look like. No pulling on the hair. I got some more heat protectant. I had a little bottle. I like it a lot, and it's almost gone. So this one was the same price as the little one, but it's 75% more for the same price. It's the Smooth and Shine Polishing. Because I'm sorry, I just can't manage my hair without blowing it out. I mean, it's probably better if I have no heat, but I can't do it. I can't do it. It's not manageable. It's not manageable. So I will have to blow it out. And so I got the heat protectant to help with that. Heat protectant. And then also, in addition to the leave-in conditioner, I got Motion's Deep Penetrating DPT conditioner, which I am actually going to wash my hair and use that. I plan to use a lot of protective styles. One of the protective styles I plan to use are the two-strand twist out. So I got some lock gel. I got this one from Organic Root Simulator. I was using Carol's Daughter. I like it, but I decided since I'm starting this journey, I just want to see what works best. So I'm going to try. We're going to try a few different things. Of course, my water spritz bottle, I've actually put Poland Springs water in here. Now, even though I can't wash my hair with Poland Springs water, when I'm moisturizing and sealing, I'm going to be using the Poland Springs to seal that in there, the spring water. Also, a couple of other things that I picked up were vitamins. You know, hair comes from out of our bodies, and our bodies need to be healthy in order for the hair to be strong. So I'm going to start with thin. I picked up some biotin. And I got this from Walgreens. I believe it was like, I think it was $3. This is for skin, hair, and nail support. And it says that biotin helps promote the health of skin, hair, and nails by nourishing cells throughout the body, especially in hair follicles, nail beds, and other and outer layers of skin. Biotin is a water-soluble B vitamin that assists protein and fat metabolism for energy use. So I've been taking these for a couple of weeks now. I just knew that I wanted to have stronger hair, and since this promoted that, I grabbed this. Also, since I was there, I grabbed some Maximum Strength Vitamin D3, which promotes bone, colon, and breast health. It's besides being an essential calcium absorption, vitamin D helps maintain healthy bones in adults and assists in maintaining a healthy immune system, so I won't get sick or prevent it. Yep, so vitamin D3, and then of course I have my multivitamin. I always take this, my one-a-day woman's vitamin. They're like, literally, they're like horse tablets. They're so huge. Can you see how big that is? But they have a lot of the other vitamins that I need in there, like my daily value, usually like 100%. Oh wow, I'm taking a lot of vitamin D. I didn't realize this had 1,000 milligrams of vitamin D. It's a 250% of my daily value. I think I might be ODing on vitamin D. Oh wow. Okay, yes, I have to pay more attention. The vitamin D in the woman's daily, actually, it has the most daily value, 250%. Everything else is like 100% of the daily value, 75%. The vitamin D is 250%, and I've been taking this and the actual vitamin D tablet. Wow, okay. Yeah, so I take that along with eating healthy. I've got my vegetables, my fruits going, making sure I get a daily intake of that. And I'm supplementing it just in case there's some areas with the multivitamin, the biotin, really, for my hair. And hopefully my nails will be better. And I think that is about it. I think that's about it. So that's what I'm going to be using for my challenge. There's a couple of other things that I'm just trying to think. Anything else that I have that I haven't shown you guys. A couple of things. One is my lustrous pink oil. I had this already, but I will be using it. It's the what is this? The oil moisturizer hair lotion. So pink lustrous oil moisturizer. And then I got the Growworks. So as I told you, I got the Growworks leave-in conditioner to stop breakage. But I also got the Growworks No Flakes Calming Scalp Oil. And that's it. Now, I got this because my scalp was very irritated. It was literally like tingling and burning to the point where I was like trying to rub it. And the more that I rubbed it, it burned. And I even got a couple of scabs in there. And not from scratching, but I didn't know where it was coming from. So I got this to calm myself, and I would put it on there, and it literally did not, it didn't do anything. It made it feel good because it went on cool, but it didn't help. So I tried to figure out what is wrong. Finally, I figured out that what's going on is I was wearing ponytails in my hair, and I was like, so my ends would not be out. I would braid the end of the ponytail. So I would split the puff from the ponytail and then do a big puffy two-strand twist and then braid the ends of my hair. And I couldn't leave the ends standing out, so I took the two puffs that were made and I would pin them into my hair. And then to try and make it look cute, I was using these decorative bobby pins that had rhinestones on it. And it looked really cute, but the problem is having those pins in my hair was scratching my scalp. So my scalp was irritated because the pins were laying on them all day. And I noticed and I figured it out because it was just in that area where I had the ponytail. So I stopped wearing the ponytail. This stuff did absolutely nothing to help relieve it. What I did is I had some shea butter, some raw shea butter that I took and I rubbed in my scalp where it was very irritated and where the scalps were. And literally, immediately, the problem went away. Immediately. As soon as I put it on there, it tingled the shea butter, and I have not. And of course, I stopped using the pins or putting them so close to my scalp. I make sure that I don't care what it is, it's not laying on my scalp, the pins or whatever. And the shea butter healed it up, made the scalp feel much better right away. I don't know what this stuff does. So I doubt I'll be using this again. I'll just slap some shea butter in my hair. And that's it. All right, so I'm going to get on this challenge. I will be uploading a video with my starting length. I'm just trying to figure out how to do the strips. I wanted to do the photo story strips to try and keep track of it. So I'm just trying to figure out the site. I think I found one called Peaky Strips. I'm gonna try that. And then once I get all that together and which outfit I'm gonna wear to measure it, then I'll load that up, hopefully by tomorrow, which is the end of the month. Okay, so that's it for now. Peace and blessings.
Molly, you can rock it straight like Oprah Winfrey. If it's not what's on your head, it's what's underneath. And say, hey, hey.